Hey guys, what's going on? I just wanted to say really quick before the video got started, thank you so much for 100 subscribers. I really appreciate it, every single one of you. It means so much to me. So to show my appreciation, these hats just came into the shop. So I bought one for you guys and I'm going to be giving it away, of course. All you got to do to be entered is just be subscribed and leave a comment. And yeah, you'll get a chance to win this hat. Thank you so much.
Oh, oh my God.
Last week, I was vacationing in Hawaii with family. I think I saw more rainbows when I was there than I had my entire life beforehand. Although the waves were perfect, the breeze was delightful, and the vibes were immaculate, I couldn't help but wonder what else these islands had to offer. Besides, this isn't a vlogging channel, it's a mountain biking channel.
Now my love, she vanished in the cold.
The bike shop actually had a pretty remarkable selection of rentals, and I was able to pick up this 27.5 Stumpy. The employees told me about places to ride, but unfortunately the closest spot was on the other side of the island. I didn't have a car though, and I absolutely was not paying 200 bucks for an Uber. So I was left to ride there. If you're a road biker, this scenic route may have been not much of a challenge. It might have even been pleasurable. But for me, a park riding shuttlecock on a full suspension bike, it was going to be a journey for sure. The trip was beautiful, but definitely a painful one. Looking back at the footage, you can clearly see my descent into madness. Let's listen in.
It is going to be a pedal though. Look like about 2 hours on a map. And this wind is not helping. I'm gonna have to get aero. Cause damn, it's pretty relentless. Oh my God. It's better be f***ing worth it. Oh, the wind is back. I've never wanted a road bike until now. Holy f***. I'm dying. It is quite pretty. Every time I check this map, seems like I haven't gone any further. I think I'm digressing. Why would you ever road bike? Please, please answer. Why would you ever do this to yourself on purpose? Now it feels like there's no wind right now, which sounds nice, but then you remember that on the way back, I'm just gonna get thrashed. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, should be up here on the left any minute now. Oh, that'd be sick. I think this might be it, ladies and gentlemen.
When I finally arrived at the spot, I didn't really feel tired at all. Maybe it was the excitement of mountain biking in Hawaii, or the excitement from how good the dirt looked.
This section looks pretty sweet though. I'm getting kind of stoked. I haven't even ridden yet. Oh, this is sick. It's all just pine needles. Oh man, I can't wait to ride this.
But as I set forward to push up the hill, I soon realized how little energy I had left. I really didn't know how steep and high the climb was going to be. So naively, one foot after the other, I climbed. The environment was beautiful and the weather was perfect. So I guess I didn't really realize that my peppy walk soon became a moderate one and then a slow one. Then, as I pushed on, I couldn't go more than 50 feet without having to lie down and take a break for 10 minutes. The closer I got to the summit, the steeper the trail got, until I was literally crawling up the hill while pulling the bike behind me. I could have turned around at any point, but we all have that fight inside of us telling us to keep pushing. So after 2.5 hours of pedaling and 2 more hours of stumbling up this mountain, I made it.
Oh. Oh my god. I don't think I've ever been this tired in my life. Oh my god.
Sitting at the top was so relaxing and such a relief. But that relaxation was kind of dangerous because there was a chance, albeit an extremely small one, that if I didn't leave soon, I wouldn't be leaving at all. So, more tired than I ever had been before, I got on the bike and began the descent.
All right, here we go. Third peak DH. I'm still so tired, but there's no place to try to be. Ooh. I serve till the sun sets beyond the get ahead of my thoughts.
The trails were pretty enjoyable and fun, and the further I got down, the more fun I was having. I guess good flow snapped me out of my trance and gave me the rush I desperately needed. When I finally got to the bottom, I wasn't in great shape. I did some vomiting, so I bit the bullet and got a cab. After some Gatorades and a trip to the hospital, I was back on my feet, ready to shred again. This was definitely one of those times where the entire journey meant a whole lot rather than just the destination. And although that's cheesy and I came here to just ride downhill, the whole adventure was a pretty meaningful experience. Thanks for watching. This has been JF Films. I'll see you next time.